Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner. Today, we're going to be getting into column level security, how you can do this by leveraging object level security to make that happen. All right. Okay. So the challenge we've been talking about is Power BI has row level security and object level security, but what do you do? How do you solve the problem when you say, I need to have column level security? I don't care, you know, I can only do row level security and I can only do full objects. How do I secure a column? Well, this solution we say, okay, let's look at how we can do that by breaking apart our solution by either a fact table or a dimension. So that we can split that into two different entities. So one does not have object level security on it, and the other one does, okay? Let's head over to my desktop. I'm going to show you that. Okay, so here I am, object level security. Now, I've basically already gone in and done that. I've created my factory seller sales with OLS. If I go over here and take a look at that inside of my model, this is really... you know, pretty much the same thing, except for I've only included in here the measures that are important to me, right? So I've determined what, you know, what items should be like locked down. And so this could be columns, like, so it could be dimensional attributes. It could be measures, as in this case, as to what people can see. I went out, I broke this table up so that I have my reseller sales, and then I've got my reseller sales with my OLS on it, right? I then went into my model, and I always forget that, to go over here to my manage roles, and I went to my new table for OLS, and I just set this as false. So anyone who's in the no cost role that I've created, they don't have access to this object level security table that I've created. Now this, I'll show it to you. So you can see right now as an administrator, I can see both, good to go. When I go into view as, and I change over to the no cost view, I can still see the reseller sales total product cost, but now I can't see the same the value that was on the table with the object level security. All right. Again, like our previous solutions, this does provide true security, right? So you can be assured that if someone is in that role, that they cannot get access to this information. It does work good for measures. It works good for dimensions. This does allow you to create self-service frameworks, so you can publish this model. And again, be assured that Report Builder A, if they have access to stuff, they can publish that out, and Consumer B, when they go in and use it, they're not going to see anything that they shouldn't have access to, okay? This method does work great with DIMs and fact tables, so quite nice. The challenge is here is that this can potentially significantly increase your model size. So if you have to be splitting out fact tables or very large dimensions where you have large cardinality and there's lots of information that gets duplicated in order to do that fact table, you know, you can increase the complexity of your model there and the size that can cause you some performance issues. Okay. But generally speaking, this is a good way of going about it. It's a secure method. It does take that engineering and that does take that work to split these items up, but this is a good way to make it work. All right. Boom. All right. So that's the third method that we have on how you can bring in column level security to start lock down the information that you have. Again, pros and cons as to, you know, when you would want to use this solution versus others. It is very strong in some ways. In other ways, it's not. Like that whole not being able to combine object level security and row level security is an issue. Hopefully they'll get that straightened out soon, but that is definitively a challenge there. You know, so you couldn't like see for some of the people in that table, right? Like, let's say you wanted to see, you could see that cost information for some people, but not for others, right? And that object level security doesn't allow for that, right? So it is a bit of a challenge, you know, when we try to break these things up. But this does work. It does provide security. It's a good solution. I hope you like this. If you did, leave a comment down below, hit that like button, share it around to your coworkers. Tell them, hey, here's another option that we have. Chris is going to run through all of them. Hopefully you find this helpful. Thank you guys very much. Peace.